So just a short introduction. I'm going to do this series of videos with every member, so either teachers or therapists that are part of Agora community and that work here, so that you can know a little bit more about their practices and what their work is here. So we start with the first video with Erica. And so Erica is practicing Thai massage at Agora. She's also teaching, and so this is what we will be talking about in this video. Thank you, Erica, for participating.
Thank you.
So could you tell us a little bit about yourself, introduce you and your path, and what are your practices that you share?
So my name is Erica. You might see me as Erica Bravani online, on my website, in my promotions. My journey started 10 years ago, more than 10 years ago. So coming from Canada, I discovered yoga there when I was in university. And this was the first catalyst for me to be on a spiritual path. So even though I felt that I had this calling before, it was yoga that became the first physical practice that I had to follow something. And then after some years, actually, my yoga practice became really stagnant and I lost a connection with it. But at this point, I was already discovering massage. I was already exploring this through friends, through people I was living with. It became in my environment. Actually, I was looking for information to understand how to feel emotions in the body. And I couldn't find any information on this. I ended up randomly in a massage course. So this is how the path slowly went into the massage. And then through that course, someone actually gave me the Thai massage gift. So she said, here, go to this place, do this work, try it. And within 3 days, I really understood, okay, this is, for now, this is the new yoga. So I really understood that there was a understanding and a learning through the Thai massage that I wasn't able to receive from anywhere else. Because all of a sudden, it was like doing this yoga practice, but with another person there. So everything seemed heightened, the meditation, the work of being very aware of ourselves, because we're not just alone doing the practice, we actually have accountability. You know, there's someone else in the room. So this is the path slowly that has brought me to here over so many years.
And could you tell us just a little bit about Thai massage for people who don't know really what the technique is like or where it comes from?
Yeah, so Thai massage has a lot of misconceptions, as many of us know. So we do the massage dressed and on a futon on the floor. So this is the traditional way. Sometimes you can have without the clothing, but the way that we are doing it now, the practice, it's with the clothes, it's with a lot of stretches, but it's also with deep compression and stillness. So we can work along an energetic anatomy system, so we work along energy lines. So it's very much an energetic work as much as a physical work. And we use compression to stimulate those lines and to promote a free flow of energy through the body. At the same time, we also have dynamic techniques, so techniques that involve more movement. And this way we can work these energy lines in a different way, a more fluid way. What else? The stretching. So this makes part of the traditional understanding of Thai massage. Sometimes people call it the lazy man's yoga because it looks like we are assisting people in the yoga postures. This is also a work of stretching out the energy lines in a way. And as well, the work is one where we are touching on all of the layers of someone's being. So we are considering it as a holistic practice where we go through the koshas. So we work on all the five bodies, the mental, the emotional, the consciousness, physical, and the spiritual. So So regardless of the physical manipulations that we do, we are considering that we are touching on all of these layers of being. So this makes part of the invisible part of the practice.
So I wanted to know, like, maybe I've received personally Thai massage before, so I really know that this technique has something very sacred and very ancient and a very powerful healing aspect. And as you say, there are many misconceptions about it, because sometimes people have this idea of, like, a, you know, like a massage that will break you in two or something like this, like only, you know, very strong moves, and or maybe not the whole sacred aspect of the practice is just forgotten. So I'm happy that you share with us your view on the practice. And then maybe could you tell us, or could you tell everyone, one or two benefits of this practice that you've seen in your patients and on yourself as well?
Yeah, so it's nice that you actually mentioned the breaking people into your part. Because especially the way I work and the way I've been trained, the way Thai massage has moved over and come into Europe, it's really also about the approach. So it's really about entering the space as a sacred space. That's involved with the intention that we bring in, certain acts that we can do. But the idea is to come in with an energy of compassion, an energy with understanding the type of touch that we are giving to the other. And through this, one of the biggest benefits that I've seen and that I've learned and understood is how we can really drop people into a very deep state of relaxation. So we're stimulating the parasympathetic nervous system through the traditional techniques, but also through their approach. So the techniques themselves work in a way that we don't need to intellectualize them. We don't need to go into a very far anatomical reasoning of fixing anyone. We use the techniques and we approach with a very soft sense of understanding that you're holding another person's body and another person's being. So we're always listening. We're always in a state of silence and listening to what is coming up through the other person and also what comes up through yourself. So in this way, the act of the treatment is a giving and receiving cycle. So the receiver is also giving, because they are giving us information that isn't even necessarily said. It's communicated through the body. And then the giver is also then receiving that.
So is it like a two people meditation sort of practice? Like, you know?
Yes, it's considered a meditation and movement. So this is because we're keeping silence, we are considering how we are listening to the body, we are considering listening to what arises in the whole space. So it's not just what's coming up from the other person's body, it's also what comes up for us. And what we feel in the energy of the space as well. So with this state of meditation and with approach of a quality of touch and compassion in the touch, and with the techniques, we can really drop the person into a state of very deep relaxation. And this is actually the place where deep healing can occur. So this is where the body starts to make its own alignments and adjustments. You know, so we as the therapists are just the catalyst, we are the support, but it's the own person's body that can start to align and do the work that it needs to for itself, because someone else's body knows much better what they need than someone coming from the outside.
Great. So to talk about a little bit the community of Agora, that is, let's say, the home for these practices, not just yoga, meditation, but also Thai massage and Ayurvedic massage, osteopathy and other therapies. How has it been for you, I guess, to come across a community like like this on your path, or how did this support your practice and your life to be joining this community of therapists or healers?
So the work of the community, of the Sangha, that we say, the other seekers of truth, the other people that are also on this path of seeking something different, seeking something that's more aligned with their essence, with their true being. This is essential. It's essential to have the family, the support, the friends, you know, the other family. Because otherwise, the work that we do in healing, in yoga, in self-healing, in personal development, whatever we feel is the spiritual path, it's very easy to become very lonely. And it's very easy to, even as teachers, you know, you are teaching your class, you're alone teaching the class. You have the students there, but sometimes it can feel a one-to-one. As a therapist, you can be doing a lot of one-to-one treatments. And it's really a place of a lot of giving. It's a place that can feel alone. And I believe that I speak for a lot of people when I say this, that we are not just doing this work for a job or a career. You know, we have another motivation behind us, a purpose. And it's important to have a community to support you in that.
Mm-hmm.
To feel that you have ground, to feel that you have foundation, that when you get more tired, you have other people to help lift you up, that other people can take, that they can give you hands when you need hands. And the emotional support that comes also with knowing that we are in this together. We are all following this path together.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sometimes when we get uncentered or unfocused, or you know, life happens and some events happen in our life, I feel like when it becomes really tough, it's easy to get completely distracted of the path, you know, to think, oh, maybe I was wrong, this didn't bring me happiness, or this didn't bring me the answers, and then jumping back into old patterns or habits, or dropping the connection to the practice or to the other people. And I also found that on my own, with my own experience, that having the other people is like a reminder, oh yeah, no, okay, we're all in this together, and it's worth continuing and, you know, having faith and doing the work, so.
And doing the work, exactly.
Yeah, doing the work, because it's all a lot of work.
It takes a lot of energy to show up for this, these practices every day.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And so you also teach Thai massage, so you also do, what kind of courses do you teach?
So I teach the beginner courses, so these are really courses for anyone of any level of experience, so you don't have to have done any previous work in massage or body work or even yoga, you can come as a complete newbie. So it's held in a very safe space that you learn the basics from the beginning.
Step one.
At the same time, if you have previous experience in other practices, if you've done other types of body work before, this can be a really nice complement also. So you learn the basics of a new technique.
Mm-hmm.
And if you've even done Thai massage before, I mean, many of us know that these courses are also a work of personal development at the same time. So often we even repeat these courses as well. So it doesn't matter how much experience you have, there's always something to learn in going back to the fundamentals, going back to the beginning, and doing the practice of the meditation, the practice of the listening, the practice of the working with the intuition, working with the touch. This is always stuff that we can be constantly developing. So in the courses, we work on all of this. It's not just a basic sequence from start to finish. Of course, you will receive that, you can have that. But they are also designed to work with honoring the practice as a sacred practice, honoring it as a traditional practice that comes from much older wisdom.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so we need to also understand how to approach the practice. practice itself in this way. So not to make it mechanical, not to divide it too much. It needs to be understood that it is a creative art. So eating, you learn the sequence, but at least my courses are designed that you can pick apart the sequence.
Mm-hmm.
So we learn and understand how to listen to the body to creatively change the sequence as we feel we need.
So it's not a dogmatic approach.